Hi folks, this is Vince with Dad's Gaming Addiction, and once again we're going to commentate on a game that Vinny and I recently played. Again, this is Star Wars X-Wing. As you can see, I am the Rebel Alliance. I have four rookie pilots, all pilot skill 2, no upgrades, and I've got a prototype pilot, A-Wing, Shardan refit. All of that came to 99 points. And then over there, he tried my build from the previous video. He's got Captain Yorna Lambda, Sensor Jammer, Mangler Cannon, and ST-321. Well, maybe not the exact build, but the same ships. He's got Omega Leader and the First Order TIE Fighter, Stealth Device Predator, and Comm Relay. And last but not least, he's got Soontir Fel TIE Interceptor, Stealth Device Push the Limit, Royal Guard TIE, Auto Thrusters. All of that came to 100 points. Alright, so, yeah, I have the game, the video sped up to times 2, just to make the video go a little bit faster, and we're going to show you asteroid placement, like we did last video. That seemed to be a big hit. Now, apologies on the crooked camera here. I thought I had it straight, but I guess not. Like, I have, like, some really low-end equipment, so... And I also have sort of a crooked house on top of that, so it doesn't make, you know, making it straight any easier. And the fact that the table keeps getting pushed, you know, there's that too. So my goal here was to sort of get these asteroids sort of clustered up as much as possible so that his Lambda would have a difficult time navigating them if he was forced to go that way. Now, because I have the lower pilot skill, I would place mine first. I didn't know where he'd place his, so I sort of spread my ships out a bit. Alright, so Yor goes first with a pilot skill of 4. And then he tried placing Soontir, but I just told him Omega was next, because that's an 8. And then Soontir is a 9. So all of his ships will shoot first and activate last, just because my pilot skill is so low. But that could be beneficial in some cases, like blocking, for example. That's what A-Wings are pretty good at, so figured I'd give that a shot. Alright, and here we are planning our dials. One of these days we'll have to try the debris instead of the asteroid, just to see how that plays out. Now his list here, he's got 2 aces, Soontir Fel, you know, with push the limit, he gets a focus evade, or maybe a bear roll, then a focus, you know, any time you get stressed with Soontir Fel, you get a focus token, so push the limit is a natural thing. And then you've got a Mega Leader, for those of you that don't know, whoever you have target locked, they cannot modify dice while attacking or defending, so against that ship, so it's pretty powerful. And the Lambda has the title, so he can take a target lock anywhere on the map. And Captain Yor's ability allows him to take a stress from some other friendly ship at range 1 to 2. All right, so I'm not wasting any time here. I'm just trying to move up, trying to get past his Lambda as quickly as possible, because that thing does not turn very well. So I was trying to prevent him from getting it together, so to speak. I did not want his ships to coordinate and get past the asteroid field in a coherent manner. So I did my best here to try and get into the battle as quickly as possible. Vinny likes the wings down, but they're in the way all the time, so more than likely we'll be moving those up. Alright, so he's taking a target lock on that X-Wing closest to the camera. Alright, Omega goes next. 2 hard turn. Now, Omega does have Comm Relay, so he can keep that evade token from round to round till he needs it. And again, this is basically a copy of my previous build. He took my build and was like, I like it. Unfortunately, he did not clear this, so he ended up bumping the Lambda here. And this is what I was talking about, the Lambda's wings needing to be up. Alright, so there we go. So no action for Soontir Fel. Unfortunately, I'm not close enough to do anything about it. Sunterfell, when you've got no actions, it's they just become a regular TIE fighter or TIE interceptor rather, and it's that's when you can kill it. That's when it's most vulnerable. But when it's got its focus evade thing going, good luck trying to hit it. Especially if it's got auto thrusters, which this one does. All right, so my prototype pilot A-wing goes first. And here I am again, getting right into the thick of things, trying to, as quickly as possible, get in there. And what did I do? I was counting on his Lambda to somehow turn into those asteroids or something. So I tried to block him here. And let's see if it works. I probably could have taken an evade just to be safe, but I knew that Soontir Fell doesn't have any one maneuvers except, a hard turn. So he would have to go forward two or three or something like that. All right, so here comes the X-Wing. It's not as fast as the A-Wing, but they can still do a three or four. All right, taking focus. The Lambda does have a sensor jammer, so more than likely I'll be favoring target locks at some point. The sensor jammer basically lets you. Well, no. What was it that he had? No, it was a megaliter. I'm sorry. A megaliter, like I said, doesn't allow you to modify dice. Well, it doesn't say anything about re-rolling them. So, target locks seem to be the way to counter that. So, doing focus actions against Omega when you're going after Omega doesn't seem to be the smart thing to do. But I knew that Omega probably wouldn't have been in range anyway. But yeah, anyway, Lambda does have sensor jammer, which turns a hit into a focus, so he'll be using that on a regular basis. He's tried moving here and unfortunately ends up hitting the corner. So he has to. What? Well, did he make it? Yeah, he made it. Never mind. I thought he wouldn't make that. All right, so he's taking a focus. All right, what's he doing? He's boosting. Okay. Push the limit. That gives him a focus, and he took an evade. And then gave the stress to Captain Yor. Okay. So, Suturn Fell shoots first. Three attack dice. Range two. Two hits, possibly? No, one hit. He didn't choose to use his focus because he knew he needed it for defense. I got an evade, so no damage on the X-Wing. The First Order TIE gets to shoot two dice. Predator. Two hits. I take one shield. Got one evade. And again, that was on the prototype A-Wing. All right, now the Lambda gets to shoot. Now it looks like he's going after my X-Wing, I think. Yep, so I lost two shields there, unfortunately. So my one X-Wing is now shieldless with three hull left. And here I am, getting ready to shoot back. Got four X-Wings and an A-Wing. You'd think I'd try and hit something. I went after Soontir Fell this entire round, just to try and clear those tokens and possibly at least hit him once to clear that stealth device. But I was rolling hit after hit after hit, but he had, either four or five defense dice, depending on the situation. At range three, he had auto thrusters kicking in. So it was kind of nasty. Asteroids protecting him. So no damage. All those X-Wings shooting at Soontir Fell couldn't land a hit. It's not what we wanted. Well, not what I wanted. All right, the A-Wing does not have a shot. Not on Soontir Fell, anyway. So I decided to go after the Lambda at range 1, 1 hit, 1 blank. He's using his sensor jammer to turn my hit into a focus, and no damage. So for the Rebel Alliance, this is a pretty crappy round. All four X-Wings shot at Soontrafel, none of them connected. That's the beauty of Soontrafel. And the A-Wing did not block anyone, which is my intention. And I've got 3 hit points lost this round. So, but the good side, you know, the good news is that the Lambda here is starting to run out of options. I mean, the Lambda has a hard time turning, like I said, so at some point it's going to pass us up. So my goal is to try and get past the Lambda as quickly as possible, and then try and burn down one of those two aces if I can. Now, lucky for me, I move first. So Soontrafel here, if he decides to go too straight, I could try and block him. And I think Vinny knows that. So he might try for something else. All right, so here I am doing a one hard turn, trying to block that Lambda. And I'm going one straight again, trying to block the Tyner Scepter in case he does a one hard turn. And here's the other X-Wing going one forward in case it does a two straight. You know, I was just trying to limit the Tyner Scepter's moves and make him hit me if I could. And what did I decide to do? Took a focus. Alright. Barely clearing that. Took in a focus there. Okay. Now, Captain, your moves ends up hitting my X-Wing and lands on top of the asteroid. So he doesn't get to shoot, and he has to roll for damage. I don't think he took a hit, though. When he rolled for damage, he did not roll. He did not take a hit. But no action, and he doesn't get to shoot. All right, so now the First Order TIE gets to move. A little sloppy there. Lots of bumping going on. We play casually, so it's not too big of a deal. And then Soontrafel. All right. Getting out of there. Probably saw that I was going after him and wanted to sort of defend himself. He's boosting out of the way. Decides not to push the limit here. Probably doesn't want to be stressed. So he can turn around or K-turn next move. All right, so the only one that can shoot is Omega. So 3 attack dice on my A-Wing, probably. Used my Vay token, and I lost... Oh, no damage. Okay, I got lucky there. Oh, no, that was on my X-Wing. I lost a shield. Okay. It's either on my A-Wing or my X-Wing, but I lost another shield. All right, so now he's defending. I think the Omega is defending. I think I switched targets here and went after Omega. Hit him once, and he lost his stealth device. Three hits, one damage. Yeah, so basically my goal is just to burn him down, one ship at a time, and 2 hits. Okay, so he's off the board at this point. Not what Vinny wanted. And Soontir is facing the wrong direction. So the X-Wing's going to take a shot at the Lambda at range 3. He gets 3 dice, 1 for range 3 and 1 for the asteroid. Alright, so he loses 2 shield tokens from that hit. Based on his roll. A-Wing's going to go after Soontrafel, but I doubt he's going to hit. 2 attack dice versus 4 defense? 5. Yeah, no damage. 1 for range 3, 1 for stealth device. Yeah. 3 normally. Alright, so the Rebel Alliance redeemed itself this round. Got one off the board. But now Soontrafel is not an easy kill, especially when Soontir's got all those actions it can take. So the question is, do I go after the Lambda here, or do I go after Soontrafel? Lambda would be easier to kill, But it's also very unlikely that it's going to be very maneuverable and get back into the action anytime soon. Because what's it going to do right now? I mean, it's sort of stuck. It could do a too hard turn here, but land on top of that asteroid again. So it's got to go straight and then make a turn if it doesn't want to take more damage or the possibility. So my thinking here is that I would go after Soontir Fell first. Try and clear him off the board while the Lambda was busy trying to turn itself around. So, and as you can see, yep, well, there's the A-Wing moving in. Taking. What did I do? I knew he'd be out of range, so I think I took a target lock, but I'm not sure. Yeah. Because I thought that he would go right or left. I'm not sure which way. Probably right. So I'd be out of arc with the A-wing. So I took a target lock just to prepare for next round. All right, so there's another target lock. Now that one ended up colliding, so no action there. Here come the other X-wings. There's another target lock. My goal was to get three attack dice every single time. And hopefully he would roll something bad somewhere. That was the goal. Not easy to do. Now here's the thing though. Most of my ships are at range 2 or 3. So he's going to have a plethora of dice. I have no focus tokens. So more than likely, I mean, I'd have another beat on him on the next round, assuming he survives. So I might want to save these target locks if I can. Yeah, now there's that. So he's definitely at range 3 on most of those ships. Focus, evade, and he's stressed on top of that. So now he's limited on his next round. So I'm thinking to myself, he's not going to have a whole lot of places to go if he wants to clear that stress. So maybe I should keep my target locks, take a focus next round, and then use that in addition to the target lock to guarantee some hits. All right, auto thrusters kicked in, no damage. All these X-wings shooting. No damage. It's pretty sad. All these, there's four X-wings chasing Soontir Fell, and none of them can connect. Here's the A-wing. I don't think we've got a solution. Okay. All right. Yeah, I didn't use any of my target locks though. I saved those for next round. I could have used the target locks, but I didn't. I thought I just in my head I was thinking that I've a better chance of hitting them at range 1 or 2. With a target lock as opposed to range 3. I just have more dice, or he'd have less dice, no auto thrusters, that kind of thing. So, yeah, I saved them. Now, the trick here was trying to get my X-wings to coordinate without rucking into each other. That was another difficulty. The more ships you add to your fleet, yeah, you got more attack dice, but at the same time, you've got to coordinate them. And that could be a little difficult if they're all clumped up like this. Yeah, I took a focus. All right. I instead of the focus, I took a boost. Okay. And that was just in case he decided to do a one hard turn. If he did a one hard turn, he'd wreck into my A-wing. No actions, and my X-wings would rip them apart. That was my goal anyway. All right, so those two A-wings on the right there, just in case he does take a wider turn, they're there, ready for him. Same with that X-wing there. And then the one in the back is just moving straight ahead, close to that asteroid. Just in case he does move like 1 or 2, just to clear. Well, he can't do a 1 unless it's a hard turn, but he can do a 2, which he just did. Okay. So that's actually good for me. So he decides to do. He can try and boost, but I don't think he's going to get out of arc. So he took a focus, stress. All those target locks, and here comes that. That's a stressful maneuver. He's turning his Lambda around slowly but surely here. All right, here comes the X-wings taking their shots. Four attack dice, no damage. Like I said, this Soontir is tough to crack. Spending my focus, three more hits. Spending his focus token to get three evades. Eventually, I'm gonna get a hit. Target lock. I don't think I got a damage there. Last one, threw an asteroid. Four X-Wings, still couldn't hit him. There we go. Yeah, now the dice, three blanks there. That's one damage I think he took. And it was a crit. It was a direct hit. So he ended up with two damage on that one. So the Suntir is down to one health now. And yeah, that's not what he wanted. And the A-Wing is off, or the A-Wing managed to finish him off. He's off the board. Man, it took five ships to take Suntirfell down. That's how ridiculously powerful he is. Okay, so all that remains is the Lambda. Now the Lambda does have, some things going for it. It's got the Mangler Cannon, and my X-Wings don't exactly have a lot of health. Two of my ships have no shields, so those criticals would be really nasty. The Mangler Cannon can turn a hit into a crit. The downside is that the Lambda is not very maneuverable, so trying to get it to get a beat on all five ships very difficult. So the smartest thing here for me would be to split my ships up and then come at them from all sides, and then just stay behind them with one with the one or two ships that manage to do so. All right, so my A-wing did a K turn, ready to go right down the middle. The X-wing is going, looks like that one X-wing's going toward the far end. Okay, that one's following, and these other two, I think, are going to go to the right. Yeah. So as I said, I'm splitting up my forces now. Unsure of where he's going to go next. So I want to try and have X-wings in every part of the board, and then converge on him. The downside is, he'll have a forward firing arc on some of those ships, but at the same time, some will be behind him. So, and that's what I want. At this point, all I need is one or two good ships behind him, and he's toast. All right, next round. And I'm thinking hard, trying to figure out what he's going to do. I don't want him to get at range 3 if I can, because that Mangler Cannon will rip me apart, even at range 3. But there is that asteroid there, which will give me a nice defensive boost. Okay, so I run into my own ship on purpose, just so I can then swing to the left around that asteroid and then try and get behind the shuttle. All right, so I bump again. I'm using the asteroid as cover, just in case he decides to use Mangler. These other ships moving up, four straight. And his Lambda is going to do what now? He's going two straight from the looks of it. Landing on the asteroid, he has to roll for damage. Hit, one damage. So he loses his shield. Not sure why he decided to do that, but now I get to shoot with my A-wing. He's going to convert one with his sensor jammer. I still get one hit through, though, and he loses another shield. He's got one shield left from the looks of it. All right, he doesn't get to fire back because, again, he's on the asteroid. That's why he didn't shoot before the A-wing. The rest of the X-Wings didn't have a solution. Okay, so this is a golden opportunity here for me to really screw him over. I don't know if you guys can see it, but there's something I can do here that will basically ruin him for the rest of the game. I'll let you see if you can guess it. All right, so I did three slight turn there and boost. Now here's the thing. When he goes to move, he's gonna, if he goes straight, well, anything really, he'll end up bumping my A-wing and landing back on the asteroid again, preventing him from shooting. So my goal is to keep him on that asteroid as long as possible while my other ships get into position and get their shots off. All right, so here comes my other X-wings. Taking target locks. All right, now these two are coming around. Now his lambda is not to be underestimated. He still has six hull left. Gets one agility. Has the sensor jammer. He tries to go too forward. Doesn't he hits the X-wing. Has to travel back along the path there. Lands back on the asteroid. So he has to roll for damage again. Takes a hit. Loses his shield. Now he's down to 5 hit points. X-wings get to shoot. All right, target lock, 2 hits, I think. He's going to turn one hit into a focus. And that was no damage. Okay. Target lock again, 2 hits. Blank. Okay, so one gets turned into a focus. The other one is a crit, I think, which is a direct hit. So he got 2 cards. A lot of direct hits this round. And the other X-Wings are just sort of hanging out back there going la la la. Eventually we'll get to you. All right, A-Wing goes first. Now, I wanted to block him again, but I also wanted to get a shot if I could. All right, so the 3K turn there, my X-Wing moves in to block. So he's got the same problem again. His only hope is to go like very far ahead or to make a really hard turn or something, but all right, so 3 and a 3. Taking a focus. Now his maneuver was puzzling to me. It was a zero. I'm like, I held out my hands like, what are you doing? He thought he was gonna rush past me. Like he was gonna sit still on the asteroid, let the ships fly past him and then move. That was his goal. But unfortunately, that's not what happened. All right, so I got 4 hits there. He rolled a focus. That's 4 hits. He's dead. So, that was the game. That just goes to show you that aces can be defeated by low-level rookie pilots and prototype pilots if they're flown right. So, if you guys want to see more X-Wing, let us know. If you guys haven't already subscribed to my channel and check out my official website, www.dadsgamingaddiction.com. This is Vince. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.